Well, good morning, church family. I hope and pray that today you are doing well and that you are strengthened and encouraged today in the name of Jesus. It is Saturday, April the 25th, and today's little devotion of hope comes from the book of Daniel, chapter 10, and the actual verse is verse 12. So Daniel chapter 10, verse 12 is our devotion today. But do want to let you know that your staff is missing you, praying for you, thinking about you. We just want you to know that you are on our hearts, and we cannot wait to get back together and worship together as a body of Christ. But again, as Pastor Zach said this last week, even though we can't meet together, there still is a purpose and a mission. And that mission is to tell people about Jesus and the gospel, and I'm praying that you're able to do that in your home, in your situation where you are currently residing. So praying for you and praying that God will continue to give you strength during this time. The devotion today comes out of Daniel chapter 10, verse 12. And what's happening in this passage is that Daniel is recounting a vision that he had of a man. And I'm not going to read all of it. I'm going to start in verse 10 to kind of get to verse 12. And then we're going to just briefly talk about the truth of today's do not be afraid. In verse 10, it says, "A hand touched me, and he set me trembling on my hands and knees. He said, 'Daniel, you who are highly esteemed, consider carefully the words I'm about to speak to you, and stand up, for I have now been sent to you.' And when he said this to me, I stood up trembling." Then he continued, "Do not be afraid." There's our verse. "Do not be afraid, Daniel. Since the first day that you set your mind to gain understanding and humble yourself before your God, your words were heard, and I have come in response to them." And that verse, verse 12, there's so much in that verse, and that it says that, "Do not be afraid, Daniel, since the first day that you set your mind to gain understanding and to humble yourself before your God, your words were heard, and I have come in response to them." And here's the truth of today and who God is and what God does. And it is this, that God hears our prayers. God hears our words. We can cry out to Him no matter what circumstances we're in or what situation we face, no matter how we're feeling, no matter what's going on in our life, no matter where we don't understand or do understand. I saw a meme yesterday that said, "This is my prayer life." It was a great meme, and it had like one of those little boards that you can place letters on and make messages or whatever. And it said, "Dear Jesus," and then it was all jumbled up, and then at the end it said, "Amen." And that seems like our prayers these days. We're so overwhelmed and so we just want this all to be over with, and I understand that. But God takes those prayers, the jumbled up prayers, and He understands it. I believe that through the Holy Spirit that it just He can understand all of our prayers. And He hears our words. And not only does He hear our words, He responds to our words. And He responds to our prayers. And He answers our prayers. It may not be what we want to have answered, or it may not be the direction that we want to go with, but He answers our prayers. He does what's going to glorify Him. And that's who God is. But He answers our prayers. He hears our prayers. But I want to kind of dive in a little bit deeper to this. And I want to talk about the two things that it says prior to him. It says, the man says to Daniel, he said, "You set your mind to gain understanding and to humble yourself before your God." And so my prayer today is this, is that God hears your prayers. God hears our prayers. But my prayer is that you daily are gaining wisdom by gaining understanding, by being in the truth of God's word and His Bible, and also that you're humbling yourself before God. That's my prayer for you today. Because God hears our prayers, but I think we must strive to gain understanding by being in His word, His God's word. And if you don't have God's word, let me know. Put it on the message us on whatever at First Baptist. We will send you a copy of God's Word. and then to humble yourself before your God. I think that's what we need to do every day. But in light of all of that, God hears your prayers. So bring it to Him. Whatever is on your heart, bring it to Him. Whatever is on your mind, bring it to Him. He will answer your prayers. Cry out to the Almighty King of Kings. He is there. Just like a great father, He is there wanting to hear from His children. Just like I want to hear from my kids. I loved it when my kids are talking to me. God wants to hear from His children, and He wants you to talk to Him in prayer. Let's pray. Jesus, I thank you so much for this day. God, I thank you for the grace and mercy that comes through Jesus. And Lord, I just want to pray for us as we are still day by day living in this season of life. And God, my heart is that I want us all to understand that you hear our prayers. God, that you hear the cry of your people. And God, that we should not be afraid, because you will answer and respond to our prayers the way you need to respond to our prayers, God. And Lord, we thank you for the freedom that we have to talk to you. And so my prayer is today that all of us, maybe we haven't prayed in a while, maybe we feel strange and uncomfortable whenever we pray, but all of us just can get on our knees today and just pray to you. And just ask you, and just talk to you, and tell us, and tell you our hearts. Lord, we honor you and love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, church family, I miss you. I hope you have a great day. Go to God today in prayer, and I know He will respond to your prayers. He will answer prayers. He always does. And I love you. I miss you. Have a blessed day. Remember to turn down the volume of the media. Turn up the truth of God's Word. Get in His Word. Get in His Scriptures. And as always, in Christ there is hope. God bless. Have a great day.